Well, good day and welcome to Tuesday Talks with Craig. It is September the 1st, and although the calendar doesn't actually mean that it's fall, usually when we kind of turn the calendar over to September, it starts to feel like fall. Here in Okotoks, the mornings have been a little cooler, and the kids are going back to school. We just sent our two girls to school this morning for their first day back. Both girls are in high school. And so this season of fall is often a season of next steps, right? For our girls, they're off to school. First day of school, it's a next step out of summer. For our youngest, it's her first day at high school, and it's a next step for her. For our oldest, it's her last first day of high school, kind of a significant one for her. So fall tends to bring next steps, whether it's a new grade at school, maybe just a new season in life. When we turn that calendar over to September, there's often sort of new opportunities or new activities. Maybe we sign up for things that we've taken a break from over the summer. And so often that fall season is sort of a getting back into things, or maybe it's a next step to something new. And especially in this sort of COVID reality that we've been in, this is kind of a next step towards reopening and going back to a sense of normal as the schools are opening up and you know, things like that. We're trying to reopen. We're trying to take some next steps to get back to a sense of normal. So for the next few weeks, I actually want to talk about next steps and this idea of, in our walk with Jesus, what would be a potential next step that he wants to invite us to take. So we're going to look at sort of invitations from Jesus to next steps with him. And so I want you to consider that each week for the next few weeks we'll talk about this. And maybe some weeks will resonate more. But just to consider what might be a next step with Jesus that he wants to take with you, or an invitation that he's inviting you to take. So today, the next step that I want us to consider is an invitation from Jesus to come and be with him. If Jesus was speaking to you, the invitation would be, come and be with me. Come and spend some time with me. I want to look at John chapter 1, starting in verse 35. Let me just read a few verses here as Jesus interacts with a couple of the disciples. So it says, "The next day, John was there again with two of his disciples. And when he saw Jesus passing by, he said, 'Look, the Lamb of God.' And when the two disciples heard him say this, they followed Jesus. Turning around, Jesus saw them following and asked, 'What do you want?' And they said, 'Rabbi,' which means teacher, 'where are you staying?' 'Come,' Jesus replied, 'and you will see.' So they went and saw where he was staying, and they spent that day with him." So here in this story, a couple of John the Baptist disciples see Jesus. John the Baptist points to Jesus and says, "Look, that's the guy I've been talking about." And so those disciples then turn and start following Jesus, and Jesus recognizes that a couple of guys are following him. And he says, "What do you want?" And they say, "We want to know where you're staying." And he says, "Come." Basically, this invitation, come and be with me. Come and spend some time with me. And it says that they spent the day with him. He says, "Come and see where I'm staying." If you've ever gone into somebody's home, you've probably gotten a bit of an impression about who that person is. You get to know people when you see their home turf. Now, Jesus didn't really have home turf, so to speak, so it kind of begs the question, what would the disciples have learned about Jesus when they went to see where he was staying? I remember a number of years ago now, moving into my college dorm room, and I had packed up a bunch of stuff from home, and some of you families can maybe relate. You've got some college students getting ready to head out maybe go and live in residence or an apartment or whatever. So when I was in college, I packed up a bunch of things that were, you know, important to me that I wanted to set up in my new room in the college residence. And so I had a flag that I put up, my Scottish flag, the St. Andrew's Cross, put that up in my room. I probably had a jersey or two that I put up of sports teams that I was cheering for. I had CDs back in the day when we had CDs to listen to. I had a stereo and a bunch of music and put that up, you know, on the shelf in my room, and different things that I set up to make my room my own. And I remember different guys on the floor that I stayed on would come into my room and they'd see, oh, you're a hockey fan, or oh, it was Scottish flag, what's that all about? And they'd begin to ask questions. They would get to know me based on what was in my room. And same way, I would go to some of their rooms and see the things that were up on their walls and see the teams they were cheering for that I didn't like. But it helped me get to know them. When we spend time with people, and specifically when we spend time with people where they live, there's a great opportunity to get to know them. And here in this passage, the disciples spent the day with Jesus. Now, I said, we're not given a lot of detail about where Jesus was staying and what the disciples would have learned about him from that experience. But towards the end of that passage, it says, the first thing Andrew did was went and found his brother Simon, and he told him, we have found the Messiah. So these disciples got to know Jesus in a way that they got to see him for who he really was. They discovered that this was the Messiah, the promised one, the one sent from God, something special about him. That day with Jesus changed those disciples' lives. And I want to encourage you to think about this invitation from Jesus to you, to come and be with him, to come and spend some time with him. A next step for you in your journey with Jesus, I don't know what your life has looked like recently. I don't know what kind of circumstances you've been going through. Maybe it's been busy. Maybe it hasn't. Maybe you've spent lots of time with Jesus. Maybe you haven't. Wherever you're at with him, I believe he's inviting you to spend some more time with him. So as a next step in your life, what might that look like? Jesus wants us to get to know him better. He wants to have relationship with us. And one of the ways to have relationship with someone is to spend time with them. So I want you to consider whatever's going on in your life, is there a way that you might be able to spend some time with Jesus? Maybe it's time in his word. Maybe it's time in prayer. Maybe you like to journal. Maybe it's time sort of intentionally journaling and like you're almost talking to Jesus as you write out your thoughts. Maybe it's some time in quiet and solitude, maybe getting away from people, maybe turning off the noise around you, the distractions around you, so that you can really just spend some time with him. Jesus wants to spend time with you. His door is always open. The invitation is always there. If we were like those disciples following Jesus around, he would turn to us and say, come, come and see where I'm staying. Come and spend some time with me. He wants to be with you. He wants you to get to know him better. So let me encourage you in the days to come, as you consider next steps. How might you take a next step towards spending time with Jesus? What might that look like? And what might you get to know about him that maybe you haven't known before, or maybe you need to be reminded of again today? He wants to spend time with you, not out of guilt, not out of coercion, just out of love. He loves you. He wants to be with you. So let me just leave you with that thought and encourage you today. Blessings on you on this Tuesday, September 1st. We'll see you again next week for another step, next step with Jesus. What might that look like for you? Take care, you guys. We'll talk to you later.